Hello, welcome to yoga. This is Dahlia in Yoga with the Cancer Support Center. Thank you for joining me today. If you have a chair nearby, that's helpful to have. If you have a yoga mat, that's great too. But if you just have a rug on the floor and something to hold on to, such as a countertop or a piece of furniture, that will do just as well. So today we're going to start with some breathing. We've been reviewing some different breath techniques. We've done some alternative nostril breathing and different types. Today we're just going to focus on stimulating a bit of circulation through the spine with spinal cord breathing. So this breath is intended to bring circulation up the spine into the brain. If you're familiar with yoga and you've done the cat-cow move, it's a similar move. We're just going to stay focused on the spine and the upper body. So if you think of your spine, there's an extension and a flexion movement. So the spine works like this, right? Forward and backward. That's essentially the same movement that we're going to be doing. And you're going to be bringing the shoulders together and squeezing the shoulders in, looking up on the inhale. Tucking the chin in and bringing the elbows together on the exhale. I'm going to move back so you can see what I'm doing with my tailbone, because the tailbone is also working in this movement. All right? So, give me a second. I'm on the floor. You could easily be in a chair. If you are in a chair, remember to sit forward on the chair. Pull the tailbone back. Look up on the breath. A big smile on your face as you inhale, and then as you exhale, tuck the chin in, bring the elbows together, chin to chest. Inhale, look up, curl the tailbone back, squeeze in the shoulder blades. Fill your lungs, exhale, chin to chest, elbows together. Inhale, look up, curl the tailbone back. Exhale, chin to chest. Breathe in, exhale, breathe in, look up, exhale, again, inhale, look up, exhale, one more, big smile in the sky, and exhale, chin to chest, elbows together, curl the tailbone under. Bringing your hands to your thighs, and we're going to complement that move, repeating it a little bit deeper with the hands sliding up and down the thighs. So remember, if this is a challenge for you, you don't have to use your hands, but we're going to repeat a few more rounds in case you found the first part difficult. Even if you participate, continue, because the more you move the spine flexion and extension, you create that movement of oxygen and circulation up the spine of the brain. Good thing. Inhale, look up and make a bigger smile. Exhale, chin to chest. Inhale, look up. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Pace up a little bit. That means the smile stays on your face even when you're exhaling. Think about moving the tailbone. So you're sticking the tailbone back, exhaling, tucking under, chin to chest. Again, breathe in, exhale, and inhale. Exhale. Breathe in, breathe out. Two more, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Bring your head back to center, close your eyes, just notice if you're feeling a little different than when you began. Let's make sure not to hold any tension in the face. So the more you smile, the less tension you're going to be holding in the jaw. Again, a smile sends a message into your cells. Remember, this is a very powerful tool in healing your body. And the more you invite your brain to have positive thoughts about that body that you've been given to live in, the more capable it is of healing its own self. If you're with us today, please let us know. Send a little comment. Let us know you're here.
position, we're going to be doing a spinal twist. So on the floor, bring your legs straight out, bring your right leg over the left. Grab that chair, I'll show you how to do this in the chair. So in the chair, again, you're going to be sitting forward, away from the back of the chair. Cross your ankles or the leg, whatever works for you. Whatever leg is on top, you're going to bring the opposite arm across the body. Same if you're on the ground. If you're on the ground, one leg is going to be up next to the knee. Pay attention to your range of motion and just do what works for you. Remember, it doesn't matter how far you go into the stretch. It's more important that you focus on the alignment of the spine. So as the arm crosses over, this hand's going to come near your tailbone. Maybe you can reach the edge of the chair. There's an arm on the chair and that works for you. Do what works. Lengthen your spine, take a breath in. And as you twist, look over your shoulder, keeping the chin lifted, close your eyes. And as you exhale, let your body twist a little deeper. Ease off on the inhale, lengthen the spine, and again, twist with the exhale. Easing off, come back to center and align your spine. We're going to change legs. So I'm rotating in the chair. My music just got loud, so allow me to adjust for that. Sorry for the interruption. Bring your left leg over the right. So again, forward in the chair. If you're on the ground, just bring the left leg over the right. Right arm crosses the body. Left hand is at the tailbone. Lengthen the spine. Take a breath in and twist, looking over the left shoulder. Easing off, come back to center and align your spine. Go to the other side. Again, I'm switching just so you can see my legs going over. A little easier angle for you to see where my hand is behind me when I rotate. Stay the same in your chair. Hand is behind you at your tailbone. Lengthen the spine. Take a breath in and twist, looking over the right shoulder. Center and align your spine. Cross to the other side once more. Arm crosses, lengthen the spine, take a breath in and twist, looking over the shoulder. As you come back, align your spine. We're going to go with a hip opener next. I'll show you how to do this on the ground in a moment, but while I'm here in the chair, you're going to cross the leg over one more time, and if you're able to bring the ankle up so that it's resting on the thigh, that's a little bit more deep of a hip opener. So you're going to play around with where that works on your body. Either it stays here, you can bring the ankle up, you can slide it in toward your groin, okay? So whatever is right for your body. In the chair, if you're in a chair, lengthen your spine. Remember to keep the space between the rib and the hips open. Also, if you add a little bit of a engagement to the abdomen, like you're trying to put on those pants that used to fit, that's a good way to think about it, a gentle engagement. Your hands are going to be on the side of the chair, just keep your shoulders up over your hips. And then point your chin out toward the middle of your room and guide your body out over your leg. So continue, you're in the chair, on the floor, it's very similar. Slide the ankle back as much as you can near the hip. Remember, it doesn't matter if you are in the posture. If you're feeling it, you're doing yoga. The other part of doing yoga is to make sure that your breath is in charge and not your brain. So as you use your fingertips to lengthen your body, look out towards your toes with that little engagement to release the hips. Close your eyes so you're inside your body. And with every breath, feel your body sinking a little closer to the thigh. And with your eyes closed, each time you exhale, see if you can feel any tension draining through the hips or flowing through your leg and out the end of the heel. In the chair, imagine any tension pouring through the hip like a waterfall. Your eyes closed so your mind is inside your muscles. Concentrate on the sound of your exhale. See if you can feel your muscles let go a little more each time you empty the breath. So you're doing the movements without effort. The more relaxed you are in the more the body will open up. This is how we can open the body and improve the circulation without straining or going into a place your body's not ready to go. Gently with your hands near your knee or on the side of the chair, lift your body back up to center. We're gonna switch legs. So extending, bring the other leg over. Again, you're just gonna adjust. Remember, if one side is different than the other, that means you're normal. Everyone has one side that's more open than the other. That's why we try to find balance through yoga. So fingertips behind you if you're on the floor, on the side of the chair if you're in the chair. Lengthen the ribs up, a little engagement with the abdomen, look out towards your toes or out toward the middle of the room. Focus on keeping the length in the abdomen as you guide your body out. Roll the shoulders forward and sink deeper and deeper with each breath. Keep the shoulders empty and the breath soft. And see if you can feel your body letting go a little more with each exhale. Fingertips are near the knee, the hands are on the side of the chair, gently guide your body back up. Good. Unwind the legs. So in a chair, you're going to fold or extend one leg out, so you're going to be near the front of the chair. You're going to go back up to demonstrate. On the floor, you're just going to be folding the leg in. Okay? So let's start with the right leg out. The left leg folded in. I'm near the middle of my chair now because I don't want to be too far forward. I'm going to be guiding my body forward. So for a forward fold, you're midway back on the chair. I like to sit on the chair without any arms because then I can sit with the leg that's long. That hip is going to be closer to the outside edge of the chair. It gives me a little more range of motion in this leg. Lace your fingers and lift your hands up to the sky. Again, the purpose of this is just to keep that tall spine. Imagine you're holding up the sky. Look out towards your toes. Keep the chin lifted so that the body stays long as you bring your body forward. Release your arms, relax your shoulders. With each breath, let your body sink a little deeper, emptying your shoulders. Three long exhales. toes. Once again, draw the abdomen in. Push your spine back. So you're going to curl up through the body, rolling with the spine pressing toward the wall behind you to keep that vertebrae open. Bring your shoulders back over your hips. Switch to the other side. So again, one leg is out, the other leg is bent in. If you're in a chair, same on the floor. Switch whatever leg you had out. Lace the fingers, lift your hands up into the sky. Push up high, draw the abdomen in, fold out from the waist. Relax your shoulders and empty your upper body. Close your eyes and remember, no one else is going to be in your body. The goal is not to be concerned about how far you go into the stretch, but instead to just put your breath in charge. Send any tension down your leg and out the end of your heel. Relax your shoulders. Keep your upper body soft. Draw the abdomen in, press the spine toward the wall and curl up through your body, one vertebrae at a time. Good. Bring the leg back in. In a chair, we're going to go for another modification of a hip opener. So this one's going to require a little bit more maneuvering towards the front of your chair. Again, I'm going to be at an angle so you can see what I'm doing. It's easier. With me at the side, you can be facing the computer as you like. My feet are going to come in as close as I can get them, and I'm going to let my legs hang out to the side as a hip opener. So on the floor, this is called butterfly. This is a variation in the chair. Just use your hands for stability anywhere that works for you in your chair. Remember, the hips are forward, shoulders are over the hips. So the hands help to lengthen the spine. You can also put your hands here and try pressing the knees out to the side. If you're on the floor, maybe your knees are up really high. That's okay. It means your legs are a little tighter. Perhaps you walk a lot. Don't worry about how much you're in the posture. If you're on the floor, you can take your arms and gently press down with your exhale. Feel yourself slouching and rolling back. Instead of sitting like this, try instead to put your fingertips behind you and lengthen the body up. Again, don't be concerned about where the legs are. Our goal is to let gravity open us. So if the shoulders are over the hips and the spine is long, you'll feel the weight shift into the hips. So this is the lung meridian. We're just opening up the lung meridian. Good. Now bring the knees together. If you're on the floor, cross your ankles. Shift to the hands and knees. Bend the toes under. Lift your hips and walk your hands back towards your knees. If you have a piece of furniture nearby, you can walk yourself back up. If you're in a chair, I want you to come up like this so you get a little bit of strength. Come forward, swing your arms, lift up, fall back. Practice lifting without using your hands. Whatever you were doing, floor or chair, come up to a standing position. We're going to work a little bit on balance as we do each class. The tree is a traditional balance posture, but I find that when working with certain people, this is a little bit easier balance using the crane, which is we're adopting from Qigong practice. Daoyan uses both Qigong and yoga poses. Again, you can use wall or chair, whatever you have. Keep something nearby just for stability. Sometimes it's important to know it's there whether you use it or not. You're going to keep your feet underneath your hips. So start with your toes together, big toes together. And then walk the heels out, keeping those big toes touching. Now keep your heels planted and slide your feet forward, and you have your feet to the outside edge of the hips. And that's a nice, square, strong place to be. Lift your toes up. I'm going to demonstrate with my hands what I'm doing with my toes. Just leave your hands to your side as you like. But with my toes, I'm going to lift them up and spread them out. So if you can see my hand better than my feet, my toes are lifted up like my fingers. Spread them out. Lay them down. What you'll notice is you'll feel all four corners of your feet as well as the toes touching the ground. Now take a breath, lift up your spine nice and tall. Bend your knees. Curl your tailbone under just a little bit. So again, I'm going to turn to the side. Stay just as you were. Knees are bent. I'm going to gently move the weight from one side to the other as my arms cross. So again, I'm here standing, showing you that as I bend my knees, mentally picturing my weight moving from one leg and then the other. So you see I have a little gentle movement. Exhale. Exhale. So the weight's moving, but my whole body isn't, I'm not popping my hips. Okay? So cross your arms, knees are bent. Put your weight over into one leg. Lifting. Try to bring the toe off the ground. Curl the tailbone under and lift the ribs. Keep a long, soft breath. Use the hand on the chair as you need to. Flex the foot and sink down. Switch to the other side. Lift up on the inhale. So we do this also in Qigong, and the reason is that imbalance is really important. It's also a flowing movement, and you can add different levels of difficulty based on how long you sustain the posture. Flex the foot, sink, and now bring the foot behind you. So try to touch your knees together. The more the knee is back, the more you feel it opening up this hip. Put the foot down, into the breath. Other side. You want to try to work up to about three breaths. If you touch those knees together, it'll help you understand alignment a little bit where you are in the posture. Exhale, and now we're going to bring the leg forward. Doesn't matter if it's high off the ground. Lift it up as much as it's comfortable for you. The higher it is, the more you'll feel it working the muscles. You also want to engage the glute of the standing leg. That'll help stabilize the pose. Soft engagement here, but you're still breathing easy. Flex the foot, put the heel down first. Shift to the other side. Inhale, lift up. Bend the knee. Sink. And all the weight just went into the leg I was standing on. I'm going to bring the foot behind me. Long body, heart's lifting up to the sky. Arms and leg behind you is empty. Breath is soft. And relax the foot back to the ground. Feel it filling up with weight as the other leg becomes empty. Exhale, lower the leg. Lift your hands up into the sky on the inhale. Lace the fingers, stretch up into the clouds. Exhale. Do that again. Stretch up. If you're in a chair, join us. Reaching the arms up, push high into the sky. Exhale. Good. Roll the shoulders. We're going to do side stretch. Side stretches open up the organs, particularly the liver in the right side of your body and the spleen and pancreas on the right, on the left. Excuse me. Bring your feet outside of your hips now. If you're in a chair, be sure that you're sitting in such a way that you can let your hands slide down the legs of the chair for support. It helps to keep you feeling a little more safe, right? So I'll demonstrate once in the chair. If you're standing, just make sure your feet are wide. Bring your arm out in line with your shoulder. Turn your palm to the sky. Inhale. Lift up. Try to lengthen the whole side of your body. If your hands and arm are a bit of a challenge in lifting, you can leave your hand bent. Just try lifting the elbow as much as you can, especially if you have scar tissue in this area. Bring your other hand toward the leg of the chair. Hand can be up. Well, the key with the arm up is to bring the arm behind the ear. That way, as you slide over to the side, you feel the stretch from under the elbow through the side of the body down to the hip. Tilt your head up to the sky. Keep your teeth away from each other. Let your ear rest toward your shoulder. Take a long, slow, soft breath. Inhale, lift your hand back to the sky. Follow it in line with the shoulder. Exhale as you return. Go to the other side. So arms in line with the shoulder. You're standing, it's the same thing. This arm is just going to be sliding down your leg instead of sliding down the chair. Okay, bring your arm up behind the ear. Long, tall arm, like you're reaching up to touch the ceiling. Exhale, slide to the side. Adjust your arm in any way that you need to for your range of motion. Let the other hand slide down the leg of the chair. Try looking up to the ceiling. If your arm is really forward, don't go so deep. Come back up and bring the arm back. Maybe don't tilt very far at all. It doesn't matter. Again, stop worrying about how far you go into the pose and just go to where you feel like you're at, your 70%. 70% is where you can sustain the posture. It also lets your body open up without getting hurt. So when you're at 70%, close your eyes. And just feel the body release with the exhale. Inhale, lift your hand back into the sky. Follow it in line with your shoulder. Slowly return. Keep in mind, no one else is going to be in your body, so if it doesn't feel right, do what you can. We're going to repeat this. We're going to add a little variation. So people that are standing, you're going to just leave your feet right where they're at. We're going to sweep our hands up into the sky. If this is not available for you because of some other scarification or injuries in your shoulder, just do as much as you can, okay? We're not here to compete, and remember, you're not being graded. So it doesn't matter how far you go. The important part is to try to get the blood flowing in through the tissues. So lift your arms into the skies just as much as you can. Maybe you have your hands over your elbows as a variation. Get creative and see what works for you. Push the hands into the sky. Keep that spine nice and tall. If you're in a chair, make your feet wide. And now we're gonna lean over to the left first. So push up to the heel of your right hand. Keep the whole side of your body long. Feel that stretch down into your hip. And now gently put the weight into that left leg. I'm sorry, the right leg. Gently lean over to the left. Push through the heel of your right hand and feel that stretch again from all the way through the arm down the side of the body into the hip. If you're in a chair, press your right hip back down toward the chair. Come back to center, release the hands and exhale. Take a breath, sweep your arms up on the inhale. Again, lace the fingers, push up into the sky. If you're standing all the weight, imagine that it's in your left leg, and as you exhale, lean out to the right. Push a little harder through the heel of your left hand, the one that's in the sky. If you're in a chair, you're going to press the left hip back toward the chair. Just push out, feeling that lengthening through the whole side of your body. Bring your hand back to center. Exhale, release your arms. Maybe that wore you out a little bit. So let's just roll the shoulders. Curl the shoulders forward and release them back. Let's take a little moment to do a bit for the neck and shoulders. So if you're standing and you want to go back to the floor, that's an option. Just sit into a chair for a moment. If you're already in the chair, we're going to be doing this motion with your arms out. So again, forward in the chair keeps you from sagging back in the chair, right? So stay forward, arms out, palms up. Bring your elbows together and roll the shoulders. So from the side, as my arms come together, I'm going to curl my shoulders forward so that I'm opening up the space between the shoulder blades. Keep drawing the elbows together. If they're not together, just pretend they are. Now open up your fingers nice and wide, like you're holding a big tray of food, welcoming back all of your friends when this is past. Spreading the fingers nice and wide, push the heel of the hands out, stretch the fingers down. Lift your little finger all by itself. Make sure you're not clenching your teeth. Exhale and lift the ring finger. So three fingers are stretching down, two fingers are stretching up. The heels pushing out and your elbows are drawn in. On the next breath, lift the middle finger. So two fingers are pointing down, still pressing through the heels of the hands and the elbows are still drawing in. Next breath, lift the index finger. Lift the thumb. Now point all the fingers toward your bicep without lifting the wrist. So check with yourself. If you had a party tray on your forearms, would you be spilling it? Lower your wrist in line with your elbows. Push through the back of the hand. Stretch those fingertips toward your biceps. Keep the elbows moving in toward each other. Again, you can roll the shoulders forward a little bit more. You feel it creating space between the shoulder blades. Now curl the elbows out. The knuckles are going to come over top of each other. So the back of my hand is going to touch. Keep your elbows lifted up in line with your shoulders as high as you can make them. Part your hands like you're parting a big wave of water. Curl your fingertips under. Roll the shoulders forward so you're really arching your back. You can see from this side, I've got a rounded spine. The reason I want to roll those shoulders forward is so that I can create space between the shoulder blades. It's the back of the heart. Now keep the elbows lifted, stretch your fingertips up, and try bringing your elbows forward in front of your body. The more forward you bring them, the more you'll feel it stretching that space between your shoulder blades. Keep the spine tall, stretching through the fingers. Release. Just close your eyes for a moment. Taking a long breath, lengthening your spine. And as you exhale, feel your body release a little deeper. Keep those eyes closed and just notice what you're feeling through the shoulders. Now take a breath and tuck your chin in to your chest. Inhale, lift your chin to the sky. Lift your lower jaw. Exhale, bring your chin to your chest. Inhale, lift the chin back to the sky. Lift the lower jaw. So the reason we're doing this is to open up the front of the throat. We're lengthening the thyroid gland. Also a lot of lymph nodes through the throat. Bring your head to center. Bring your right ear over top of your right shoulder. Again, empty your arms. So the arms are heavy. Eyes are closed and the breath is soft. Make sure you're not holding on to any tension in the face. So keep your teeth slightly parted. Your mouth can be closed. Just put your tongue behind your teeth. Relax your forehead. With every breath, feel your ear getting a little more heavy, coming a bit closer to your shoulder. So you're stretching without straining. Again, invite any tension to move across your shoulder, down your arm, and out the end of your elbow. Feel free to keep your eyes closed as you bring your head back to center. And now we're going to go to the other side, bringing the right ear over the right shoulder, sustaining a heaviness on your elbow. Left ear to left elbow. Left ear to left shoulder. Right arm is heavy. Breath is soft. So is your forehead. And keep your teeth parted and the jaw relaxed. See if you can notice how those muscles extend and reach from the cranium, through the neck, through your shoulders, down into the arm. Bring your head back to center. Take a moment. Eyes can be closed. I'll tell you when to open them. Just notice how your body feels now and how it feels and the difference in how it feels now and how it felt when you started. And go back to the hips. If you're in the chair, again, there's no wrong. You're just going to do what you're able to do. If you can move forward as much as you can on the chair, hand to one knee, we're going to make circles with that knee. So rotating the hip, try to bring it out to the side and in. You'll do one leg at a time. If you're on the floor, the goal is to use both knees. So on the floor, looks like this. Knees are at your chest. You're going to rotate your knees out to the side and toward the chest. If you're doing one leg in a chair, do three rounds in one direction, three in the other. On the floor, try to come all the way out so that you feel the tailbone rotating back in toward the chest, out to the side. Now switch legs, so reverse in the other direction. This massages the kidneys and the lower back. Also coming all the way out of the tailbone, connects to the brain. Now bring your knees into your chest, give yourself a nice hug. If you're on the floor, you have two options. One is to roll onto the side and bring yourself to a seated position, placing your hand near your heart, lifting up. If you want to have a little more fun, just rock the length of your spine. And remember, this rocking helps again to stimulate the craniosacral fluid in the spine. Come to a seated position. So that's the floor movement in the chair. Again, make sure that you take a minute to position yourself so that you feel secure in the chair. Let's take a moment to come back to our breath. Just remember that is the central quality of doing yoga. So we're going to come back to the breath ball and come closer.
I break this down because I don't want you to get too tired, and I also want to remind you that yoga is really about the breath more than the movement. And the more you get used to using your breath, the more it will be helpful for you when you need it if you're stressed out. So lift the spine, keep those ribs up away from the hips. Follow along if you're able, just breathe in. Long, slow breath. Sustain that breath in your body for a moment. Exhale. Completely empty the breath. Again, breathe in. Feel your ribs expanding out to the side. Sip in a little more breath if you're able. Exhale. Again, breathe in. Exhale. Last one, breathe in. Exhale. Feel your belly button moving in toward your spine with your exhale. Let's do one more upbeat breath. Again, we're doing this in case you feel a little extra dis-ease. Maybe you're feeling frustration at the situation that's at hand right now. Maybe you made a mistake and turned on the news. There's a lot of comedy. Just remember that. If you have the internet, you can get some good things on YouTube. So I recommend that. If you're feeling stress, find something that'll make you laugh. Try laughing at yourself. You may even laugh through this. We're going to breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth with a heavy exhale. Ready? Inhale. Let it go. Breathe in. Keep the tall spine. Keep the tall spine. Exhale. Out through the mouth. Inhale. Out through the mouth. Three more. Inhale. Try three more. Can you do three more? Only two more, I promise. Inhale. Last one. Good. Now, rub your hands together, get them nice and warm. Lay them on your face. Keep a soft touch with the hands lightly laying across the face. Invite any lines of tension to relax. Now, just let your fingertips brush lightly over your skin, down your face. I'm going to keep repeating this through the classes as a reminder how easy it is to gain a sense of letting your face relax just by this little gentle touch. In this time where many of us are starved for touch, we can use this light, gentle touch on the face, up the front of the face, softly out to the outside edges and under the chin. Breathe in. Just imagine you're washing your face with fresh spring water. Do two more rounds. See how light you can keep the fingers on your face. Maybe you slide out a little wider under the chin. Do one more. Good. So that brings the oxygen up under the skin. It has a revitalizing effect on the body. It allows you to feel a little less dis-ease in the face, because the face holds 80% of your daily tension. We're gonna go back to the spine. We're gonna do a variation of spinal cord breathing or twisting all together. So back to the chair.
Or the floor. If you're sitting, legs are crossed. Just bring one hand across the other knee. Twisting. Come back. Sink down. Lift up. Curl the tailbone back. Go to the other side of the twist. Come back, sink down. In the chair, your feet are the width of the chair legs. Same, forward on the chair. Sink, lift, twist. Why this move? Because it massages the spine. Give a little opening to the kidneys and adrenals. Remember, adrenals are what regulate the immunity system. And twisting is what helps to stimulate circulation through the organs. So it helps you detox your body. If you've been sitting around eating maybe too many potato chips or candy bars, twisting poses are the most beneficial for you. And the more you keep the organs flush with toxins, the more efficient they'll work. So twist. This way to wake up the body. Rock, lift, twist. Coming back. Rock, lift, curl the tailbone back, twist to the other side. Good. Coming back. If you're on the floor, you'll come to your hands and knees. If you're on the chair, I want you to come off the chair, face the chair, come over the chair like this. If this is too low, you can always use the back of the chair as a variation. Okay? So you're either on your hands and knees or you're leaning over the chair. I'll show you here and I'll go back to the floor. Step one foot back, push down the heel. See how my knee is over my foot if I'm standing? You want to be very careful to make sure that your foot is close to the chair, so your knee is touching the chair. That way when you step back, you see the difference in where my knee is. I want my knee over my ankle. It's stronger and better alignment, and it won't put any pressure on your knee. So my heel is up in the back leg. I'm going to push back as much as I can. Remember, it doesn't matter how far you go into the stretch. This is a lunge, so stay here if you're on the chair. If you're on the floor, you could be here. If you have knee issues, use a pillow. Leg comes back, push. I want my knuckles to not my wrist. So you could use your fingertips if you want to strengthen your tendons, the knuckles to save the wrist. If you're standing or on the floor, switch to the other side. So remember, people standing, put your knee right next to the chair so you have the alignment of the knee over the ankle. Bring back the other foot, push into the heel. Bring the knee under the hip. One more time to the other side. So we're going to switch back. See if this is available for you. If not, just switch legs. Both legs come back. So it's a plank if you're on the floor. If you have the chair, it's a similar thing. Your hands are going to be on the side of the chair. Feel the engagement of the abdomen. That makes it a little easier to engage the abdomen. Look straight ahead. So you don't want your head to drop. Remember, gravity's always sinking us down. We want to keep up. Good. Step forward. Bring your body up. If you're standing, you can come to the chair again if you need to rest. People that are on the ground, just come to a seated position with your legs straight out. I'll demonstrate this in case you're in a chair today. Hands are going to come behind you. You're going to squeeze in the shoulders. Lift your heart, let your head lift up. So we're doing a little back bend. Here on the floor, same thing, lift up. If you're familiar with tabletop and that's available, you could lift the hips. The key is to squeeze in the shoulders and lift your heart up to the sky. So that's the third level. This is the first. You're just going to find a variation that works for you, okay? If you're here, our key is to get the shoulders open. Most people now, particularly in their shut-in moments, are spending a lot of time like this. They're either reading, doing something with their hands, or typing on a computer. And this is going to create a lot of issues with digestion because you see I'm sinking. You also end up with neck issues. So remember, at night, it's particularly important to help to draw the shoulders back and let your head hang back. So let's do two or three of those. People who are more advanced, if you know fish pose, you could go into fish. If you're just bringing your legs out, come onto the floor. Quick demonstration, continue if you're in the chair, seated. Otherwise, if you're here, you want to straighten the legs, come onto the elbows, hands under the glutes, walk in your elbows, lift the chest, let your head fall back. Gently bring your body back up. Breath in. If you're in a chair, I want you to widen your legs. We're going to do a forward fold. So your legs are going to come out to the edge of the chair. You're going to lift the ribs and you're going to fold forward. If you're on the ground, same thing. All of us are going to lift our hands into the sky. Look out at your feet, fold from the waist. So we're lengthening the lower back. In the chair, just widen your legs and let your chest lean forward, drape your head. Softening the shoulders. With every exhale, let your body release a little deeper. Keep your eyes closed so your mind is inside your muscles. Breath, release a little deeper. drawing your abdomen in. Curl the tailbone under and push your spine back as you roll up through your body one vertebrae at a time. Notice the difference in how you feel. We're going to do one more thing for our legs before we do another fold and end our class. That hour went very fast. So I'll come back to the chair, but while I'm here, fingertips behind you. Please stay off the wrist, save them. Use your fingertips like a kickstand, bend your knees. Lift your ribs away from your hips. Lift one leg. Try to bring the ankle in line with the knee. If you have weak knee muscles, take your heel, point it in so the toe is pointing out at a 45 degree angle. Lower the leg. Go to the other side. People in a chair, lift forward, lift the leg. Ankle in, so the heel's pointing in toward the other knee. Feel the engagement of your abdomen here. Ribs stay lifted. Try squeezing your shoulders back so that your heart is open to the middle of the room. Bend the knee and lower the leg. The other side, one more time. So you're gonna lift. Try turning the heel in if you haven't yet. Or push through the foot. Bend the knee, lower the leg. Other side, lifting the foot, push the heel out. Bend the knee. Plant the foot down. Take a breath in if you're in the chair. Scoot back. If you're on the floor, straighten your legs. Bring your hands behind you and squeeze in your shoulders. Put your chin fold out. Lift your arms up and let your head hang. Same thing. So have the arms up. Lowering your arms to your tailbone, lift your nose and chin. Bring your hands all the way back. If you're in a chair, feel free to fold forward again with your arms empty to your side. Otherwise, bring yourself all the way to the floor. Bring one hand or both onto your abdomen. Soften your face. Feel the rise and fall of your breath. Bring a smile onto your face. If you're folded forward in your chair, reach around the back of your legs. If you're on the floor, bring your knees into your chest and wrap your arms around your legs. Draw your knees into your body. Bring a bigger smile to your face if you're folded forward, your knees to the chest. And remember, that smile is for you, sending a message into the cells in your body. And gratitude that you're taking the time today to be with yourself and your breath. Now gently rock over onto your side if you're on the floor. If you're in a chair, draw your abdomen in, curl the tailbone under, curl the spine toward the back of the chair and roll it up. On the floor, the hand that's on top is going to press into the floor to bring yourself back to a seated position. It's okay to keep your eyes closed as you like. I want you to just be inside your body and notice where you're feeling any differences in how you felt when you started. Bring your hands to your heart. Leave your little finger and thumb together and open up the three fingers in the middle, creating a lotus flower. Remember, the center of the palm connects to the heart meridian. So bring that in close to your heart. Tilt your chin in. Bring a smile back to your face if you've lost it. Just take this moment to pay gratitude for being inside of a body that you've had an opportunity to honor today. And if your mind goes a little crazy this week, bring your intention back to your breath. Soften and slow, make it even. You know that each time you exhale, you're letting go of everything your body doesn't need. So look deep into your lotus flower and take a big smile. Know that that smile is brightening the light within you. That light is there to brighten your path as you guide forward in the journey you chose for yourself. Thank you so much for being here with me today. It was my honor. I look forward to seeing you Monday at 10:30 for Qigong or next Thursday at 1:30 for yoga. Namaste. Have a beautiful day and a wonderful weekend. Bye-bye. Breathe deep and smile.